did you know that water is made out of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen? And if those elements are separated out of the water, one would be explosive and the other one would promote burning? Really? We're going to use electricity to break water into its elemental components in this science snack called Having a Gas with Water. You're going to need some safety goggles, a lighter or some matches. I recommend using stainless steel screws because they won't corrode. A measuring device like a spoon, a 9-volt battery. I highly recommend using a carbon zinc battery. Do not use an alkali and especially don't use a lithium battery. Two test tubes, but use the thicker walled ones, also known as combustion tubes. Two wooden splints. I recommend using Epsom salt to be your electrolyte. Don't use table salt, because the chlorine in table salt can make chlorine gas. You're also going to need some oil-based clay, also known as plasticine. Don't use Play-Doh for this activity. It has too much salt in it. Two rubber bands and a clear cup. Hi, my name is Eric Muller of the Exploratorium Teacher Institute, and I'm going to show you how to build your electrolysis device so that you can do the activity Having a Gas with Water. What I do is I cross over the terminals with my rubber band and I go over it in this direction, which crosses over both leads, and then I put the rubber band 90 degrees over that other rubber band this way second. After you do that, you have a placeholder for your stainless steel screws. Put it underneath your rubber bands. Make sure they touch either the positive or negative terminals, but make sure that your stainless steel screws do not touch. Otherwise, if these screws touch, your battery will short out and your experiment might not work. This is going to go underneath the water. So to protect it from being in a underwater and actually salty water environment, you're going to need to protect this and make it waterproof. Take the oil-based clay or plasticine, and I put pieces all around the battery. So before I keep going, I'm actually going to make a plus sign right there to know which is going to be the positive lead and which is the negative one. Filling in any gaps so that water can't leak in. And what's really important is around the screws, I put the clay so that it's nice and tight around them. Ready to go with our electrolysis device. Now it's time to have a gas with some water. So, what you're gonna need to do is get your source of water, pour it in your cup, and then you're going to put in some Epsom salt. Turns out that tap water doesn't conduct electricity all that well. You gotta put some electrolytes in there, like Epsom salt, magnesium sulfate in there to kind of help speed this process up. I recommend putting your safety goggles on and add your electrolytes. I usually put about a teaspoon in. The amount doesn't matter that much. Stir it up, make it dissolve. When I put my electrolysis device in there, I want to be able to capture the gases, and I'm going to capture them inside of these test tubes over here. But it helps if these test tubes have the same kind of salty water as the container itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill up one test tube, totally to the top. There's a little bulge in the top called a meniscus. And another test tube, totally to the top. Just to let you know, it's a little bit easier to do this if you have a partner. But it should still work with just me alone. Now, I'm going to put my electrolysis device inside the water. Make sure that when you put it in, you point it so that it'll be easy to put your test tubes on those stainless steel leads. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this full test tube. I'm going to put my finger over it. It's going to hold the liquid in there. I'm going to turn it upside down. I'm going to put my thumb underneath the surface of the water. I'm going to move the test tube over one lead. I'm going to turn the next one over also. I'm putting this one upside down. put it underneath the surface of the water, move it over the other stainless steel screw. Now I see gas bubbles coming off of those stainless steel screws. I can see those bubbles starting to rise up inside the test tubes, and they're being captured and collected for further use. You're gonna have to let this sit for at least a few hours, if not overnight. The molecular formula for water is H2O, where H stands for the element hydrogen and O stands for the element oxygen. In this simplified model of what's going on, these are the two test tubes that we submerge in the cup, with one placed over the positive terminal of the electrolysis device and one over the negative. In a glass of water, many of the molecules naturally separate out into hydrogen ions, H+, that are positively charged, and hydroxide ions, OH-, that are negatively charged. Since opposite charges attract, the oxygen-containing hydroxide ions migrate toward the positive electrode, and the hydrogen ions migrate toward the negative electrode. Elementally, both oxygen and hydrogen prefer to be diatomic, or two-atom molecules. At the positive electrode, oxygen atoms get pulled from the hydroxide ions and then combine to make oxygen gas, O2 bubbles. Likewise, at the negative terminal, hydrogen ions combine to make hydrogen gas, H2 bubbles. One of the test tubes will fill faster with gas than the other. Since there are twice as many hydrogen atoms available to form a gas, the volume of hydrogen gas that forms should be greater than that of the oxygen gas. So now it's time to test the gases in our electrolysis device. So this, according to my battery over here, this is the positive terminal. So my guess is that this is the oxygen and this is the hydrogen. Another way to tell is that this one is totally empty and this one still is bubbling away and has more to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to light my splint on fire. I'm going to hold the test tube kind of at a downward angle because if it is indeed hydrogen, it will leak up really quickly. So I want to capture that gas, and here I go. Whoa, that's definitely hydrogen. Let's try that again. A little bit smaller. I'll see if I can get a third one. If you notice, I'm putting it back in just to kind of keep the hydrogen in there until I'm ready. Oh, so we got two on that one. So now it's time to see if the other one is oxygen. So I'm going to let this blow out. And now it's just a glowing piece of wood. If I can add oxygen to it, it will burst back into flames. So let's see if this is oxygen and makes that turn burst back into flames. Ready? Here we go. Burst back into flame. That indeed is oxygen. There you have it. Water is made of hydrogen and oxygen.